going on, Mr. X? Hey, if you missed it, a few days ago, we gave away two statues to some awesome supporters of the channel, plus a runner-up prize. I guess, what do you call a runner-up prize? Third place? First loser? Today is the first of the month. I'm pretty sure it is. It is the 1st of August, 2023, and we're going to continue doing what we do. That means we're going to grow the channel so we can give away more statues for you. But to do that, we got to get some exciting stuff happening. So that's what we're going to look at. What's exciting in August 2023? And a quick look back on July of 2023. Cheers. Hey, my name is Mr. X. Welcome to the Extreme Channel. We are giving away $1,000 statues to you guys. If you want to know how to win one, stay tuned for later in the video. Hey, thank you so much for tuning in. Yes, it's a new video. It's a new month, so you saw a new giveaway video. I just filmed it. That's why I'm wearing the same clothes, but I have like four of these shirts, so I wear them all the time. But today is August 1st, 2023 that this is launching. So we're going to talk about collecting. We're going to talk about an extreme lifestyle like we do at the first of every single month. First, I want to do a quick... Did I say quick? Yeah, let's do a quick look back on the month of July 2023. Now, it was weird for me because I was only home for 6 of the 31 days of July, which is nuts, especially since August looks to be just as bad. But during that time, some exciting things happened. I actually took my family on 3 different trips. I teased my kids. They were in 6 different airports, which for me is normal. But we still had some really exciting things when it comes to collectibles. And I always like to look at kind of my favorites that arrived. Believe it or not, my favorite was XM Studios Super Scroll, which I filmed things in advance, so that may or may not have already resold. Go back and check out that video. It alludes to another video, which alludes to another video, and then it gets all complicated. But I also wanted to look at all the statues that I purchased in the month of July. As another reminder, I started retiring. I'm trying not to buy anything. And guess what? I bought 0 in July. I did not buy a fucking statue, probably because I was traveling so much. I did score NFL season tickets, so I'm going to make a video about that when preseason starts. 50-yard line, row 5, and the all-inclusive club is pretty extreme if you ask me. Probably why I didn't buy any statues, because that was a little more expensive than a statue. Back to the subject at hand, there were a bunch of statues I wanted to buy, but practice hashtag restraint. Not only due to the NFL tickets, but a ton of traveling coming up despite the huge number of trips that was in July. So let's look at the stuff I wanted to buy, but I didn't. First was Primewood Studios released their Batman on Throne. I think this looks great. Unfortunately, I think it's just going to be way too big.
Hey, that's what she said.
I was also really impressed with PCS's RoboCop. Now, this was revealed before Comic-Con, and then I saw it in videos at San Diego Comic-Con. A lot of cool stuff at Comic-Con, which I actually blog about a lot of those at theextremechannel.com. There's daily blogs on there on new statue reveals when it's officially revealed, so make sure to check that out. The link is in the description below, or you could just type in theextremechannel.com. I also like this quarter-scale Vecna from Stranger Things that came out. Almost pulled the trigger. Unfortunately, it just wouldn't go with anything in my collection, and I want to see how Stranger Things Season 5 rolls out. I wonder if the villain will return, even though they're dead, if I remember correctly. I saw a custom thing that I absolutely loved. This looked amazing. I had the chance to jump on it, but I didn't because I already own a thing, and that's part of hashtag restraint and being an adult and trying to get out of the hobby. Lastly, saw pictures at Sideshow Con of the Chainsaw Man from Primewood Studios. Still haven't watched the anime, but my God, this looks good. If I'm going to break, if anything's going to break me, it's going to be this statue. I feel like I'm going to become weak and end up buying it, but for now, it still landed on the hashtag restraint list. Now, moving forward, let's look at the month of August. I want to talk about the exciting things that are happening. I'm traveling all the time for work. Do have a very exciting trip, but it actually falls on September 1st, so I'll talk about that next month when this video actually launches. But if you might have noticed from recent videos, I'm focusing a lot more on traveling, not just for work, but for family. One of the big trips we made last month is actually there's going to be a video in a few days. So if you like stuff like that, another reason to say subscribe to the channel and hit that bell notification. But more importantly, do it so we can get to 35,000 subs and we can give away some more statues just like we did a few days ago. Now let's talk about August. What's going to happen in August regarding the Extreme Channel? I already teased a little bit. We're going to do a video on collecting. We got some really crazy videos. One of them is why I'm a hypocrite. This piece right here, I actually haven't unboxed yet. Primewood Studios The Drowned. I do have it, so you will definitely see that. A few other travel videos besides the one I alluded to. But we have a bunch of statues scheduled to come in. So again, some of these have shipped, some of them have not. There's only about 10 or so. I feel pretty confident about a lot of them. First, for sure, I know this piece will come in. It was painted by S7 Customs. He actually teased some photos on his Facebook page, so make sure to check that out. But it looks absolutely amazing. My hand of God, I'm about to tell Big Bad at Toy Store to stick this hand up their ass because it was supposed to ship in November, and now they won't even give me any updates. So we'll see what happens with that. This Dio, if you recall, it comes in with two different torso switch outs. I paid for shipping on this over a month ago. I need to check to see if I actually have a tracking number. But another one I paid for shipping on recently was from the same group or a similar group, is this Magneto on Throne. I bought this on a whim, I think, before it was revealed. I'm going to tell you more about that when it actually arrives, but very interesting piece, and I have a lot of thoughts on it, both positive and negative, and not negative about the statue, but you'll see what I'm talking about when it arrives. This custom Batman on Throne. So they had a few early production pieces. They sent one to a French reviewer, and they're gonna make some changes because of that, but they're sending the other one to me. So I paid them in full, and I'm gonna get it shipped, so you will see the review on that after they make the slight tweaks. That's exciting. Sideshow's Evil Queen was delayed till August. Well, it's August. So it should come. Pretty stoked about that. You've seen that in a few different ones. Mrs. X, my wife, will be on that review because that statue is for her. P.S. at Comic-Con, they revealed the new one. I can't remember who it was, but I really... Oh, Aladdin, Jasmine. I really like that one. So I'm stoked to order that one as soon as it goes up for P.O. For the wife, so it doesn't count towards me, right?
Confirm Primewind Studio Zack Snyder Justice League Black Suited Superman. That's a mouthful. Is arriving in the month of August, probably in the first or second week.
Primewind Studios Punchline and Joker, again, was supposed to arrive in a container in July. It didn't. So then, in theory, it should arrive in August. Very excited for these pieces. Going to round out some of my DC collection. This custom Venom, the painter behind it actually was sick, hospitalized. So unfortunately, it was slowed down, but I'm confident it will ship in the month of August, which is pretty cool. I have tracking for Primewind Studios' reissue of their big chap, Alien, from Alien 1. Really excited about this piece, as I missed out on the first one, and I didn't actually like the wall, so the fact that this comes without a wall is really exciting to me. That's it. I'm done. That's all that's coming. But if you want to see any of those, I'm going to do detailed videos on everyone, including some of that additional content I tease. So, third time I'm asking, please subscribe. I want to get to 35,000 subs. And give away another statue to you guys. If not, three more statues. I don't know why I'm whispering. As we try to grow this channel, we like to reward you guys for watching and subscribing. So because of that, every 5,000 milestone when it comes to subscribers, we give away a couple $1,000s worth of statues. We've actually given away over 20 statues. To win one was easy. First, you gotta be subscribed to the channel. You'll get bell notifications when videos drop. Each video that drops, you want to make a comment on those videos. We pick a random video, we give away statues based on a comment. You can say whatever you want. The more videos you comment on, the higher your chances are to win. It's a new month. It's a new giveaway coming up. Let's do it. Please subscribe, comment. I appreciate you guys so much. That never gets old because I really mean it. Hit the like button. I'm out.